I'm Jennifer Weigel, Chicago Tribune reporter, coming to you from the Tribune studios. And joining me via Skype is sports columnist Steve Rosenblum to talk about last night's 3-2 victory for the Hawks in triple overtime. Rosie, what do you think? Are there still some refs circling around on the ice making bad calls out in California?
Jen, there's always referees circling the ice willing to make bad calls or non-calls. That's a fact of life in the Stanley Cup playoffs. But the game last night was a tribute to the Blackhawks' ability to survive the punishment the Ducks wanted to dole out. They want to beat up the Blackhawks' defensemen. They want to pound all of the Blackhawks' stars. They want to deliver hits. They want to take them out of their game. And there it was. In the sixth period, the Blackhawks were going D to D, moving the puck from Johnny Oduya to Brent Seabrook. He whacks a puck out of midair. Marcus Kruger slows it down and then pokes it into the net, and the Blackhawks get out of Anaheim with a split, which is a spectacular, spectacular result.
So we've got Game 3 and Game 4 coming back home here at the United Center. What do you expect to happen, Rosie?
I think the Hawks will get Patrick Kane going, and maybe you'll see something from Jonathan Toews you haven't seen so far. The Blackhawks will have the last line change because they're at home, which means Joel Quenneville will get better matchups for Patrick Kane, who hasn't scored in this series, doesn't have a point in this series, and he'll get better matchups for Jonathan Toews. The top line needs to produce for the Hawks to win to get to the Stanley Cup Finals.
Yes, and hopefully they'll produce before that third overtime so we can all get a little more shut-eye. What do you think? What do you say?
I need a nap, Mom.
Okay, go take a nap. Game 3, Thursday night, 7 p.m. at the United Center. We'll talk to you after that one, okay?